Okay, friends, now we are going to talk about the measles virus. And I believe you all know what measles virus is. At least at some point of time, you have seen this infection and generally affecting children and infants. So what is measles infection? What is measles disease? How measles virus infect? How they spread the disease? And what is the life cycle of measles virus? Let's talk about all of this. So the very first thing is the general properties of measles. It is a highly contagious infectious disease caused by measles virus. A viral infection that's serious for small children but is easily preventable by a vaccine. The vaccine is available that can prevent a child to get this infection. But if a child gets the infection, it's not long lasting, it is short lasting, but it's very highly contagious. And how much contagious? Let's talk about. It's a contagious disease affecting mostly children. And how much contagious we are talking about? If this infection happens to a child, then if 10 child comes in contact with the infected child, 8 to 9 out of those 10 healthy children will incur this infection. That's how common, that's how deadly contagious this infection is. Not deadly, but contagious. The structure, let's look at the structure. In the left hand side, we have the 3D structure. In the right hand side, the schematic cross section. And what we have is a genomic RNA and nucleoprotein present in the center, and surrounding which it has matrix proteins known as capital M. Fusion proteins are at the periphery known as capital F in this picture, and it has lipid membrane that surrounds the matrix protein that surrounds the nucleocapsid structure out there. Phosphoprotein is also there along with the RNA genetic material inside the capsid. Okay, so the capsid or the genetic material RNA contains it's associated with the phosphoprotein, and in the membrane structure outside it has a lipid membrane, it has matrix protein M and fusion protein F. With the help of fusion protein, it fuse with the target receptor, and with matrix protein it has a proper tegument structure built. So it's an enveloped, non-segmented, single-stranded, negative-sense RNA virus. The diameter of this virus is 100 to 250 nanometer on an electron microscopy. So it is showing 100 to 250 nanometer means it's a big virus. Okay, moderate size to big size virus. And measles virus encodes at least 8 structural proteins which are designated with the different letters F, C, H, L, M, N, P and V. All these different proteins have different roles to do, which I'm not going to talk about today, but it produces at least 8 different structural proteins that helps to build the structure. What is the genetic material? Single-stranded negative, so minus sense or negative sense, single-stranded RNA acts as a genetic material. Okay. What is the incubation period? Generally, measles have 10 to 14 days of incubation period. They include cough, runny nose, inflamed eyes, sore throat, fever, and red blotchy skin rash. Okay, so basically skin rash. We have already seen that earlier. The classification, kingdom Orthonaviri. The class, Mongivirids. Family, Paramyxoviridae. Species, measles, morbillivirus. Measles, morbillivirus. Okay. So, route of transmission, measles is one of the most contagious of all infectious diseases. As I mentioned, up to 9 out of 10 susceptible persons with close contact to a measles patient will develop measles. The virus is transmitted by direct contact with infections or droplets or by airborne spread by breaths, coughs and sneeze. Not only coughing and sneezing, but with breath also it spreads. That's how it's highly contagious. What are the symptoms of measles? Pain area in the muscles, whole body, we have fever, malaise, fatigue, loss of appetite, and there is also skin rash, and that is a typical identifying marker for this infection, that is red blotchy skin. Nasal, runny nose or sneezing, and skin rash is the most common. Conjunctivitis can be there, dry cough, diarrhea, headache, complex spots can be present in the body, sensitivity to light, sore throat or swollen lymph nodes. All these are, you know, swollen lymph nodes, sore throat, dry cough, these things may be, you know, we cannot judge based on these features whether it's measles, but we can easily judge based on the characteristic skin rash, which is unique for this. In case of rubella virus, we've seen earlier that there are blister-like structure. But in this case, in case of measles, there are skin rash, not blisters, but red colored rashes. Now let's look at the life cycle of measles virus. So here comes the virus, and the virus takes entry, you know, by proper interaction to the receptor on the surface of the cell, which is not shown in this picture. It's pretty much simple picture. The virus delivers its virus negative stranded RNA genome in the cytosol, and then replication of minus strand is done to make plus stranded RNA. Okay, and then this minus strand is also being transcribed into viral mRNAs, plus stranded RNAs. This will become viral mRNA. While plus stranded RNA will be further, this plus stranded RNA will make viral proteins. So we call it first degree transcription, where this negative stranded RNA is used to make plus stranded RNA, and that plus stranded RNA is used and to make viral proteins. So viral proteins are prepared, that is the all these 7-8 different kinds of viral proteins that are prepared for assembling the virus. And on the other hand, the plus stranded RNA is used as a template to make minus stranded RNA, which will act as a viral genome. So once the viral genome is prepared, viral proteins are prepared, then the proteins are arranging themselves, and the viral genome is packaged inside the viral protein, inside the viral capsid structure, and the fully formed viral particles are ready to get out of the cell by burst open the cell. And also it can go out of the cell without busting the cell, or with busting the cell. In any of these cases are possible. So that is the very simplistic understanding of how this viral life cycle will work, just like any other negative stranded RNA viral life cycle. Okay, so that's the idea about the measles virus. Very, very highly contagious measles virus infection disease, and targetedly attacking children. Okay, but it may also spread in adults, but very rarely, generally occurs in children. And generally, if a children gets vaccinated for this virus, it is easily preventable, and the vaccine works really well against this virus. So that's it. That's all about measles virus and measles virus disease, measles virus life cycle. So if you like this video, please hit the like button, share this video with your friends, subscribe to this channel to get more videos like that in future. Thank you.